Good morning. My name is Bill Habether. I'm with the Bethel Park Historical Society, and I'd like to welcome you to our first annual Breakfast with Santa. And we also have another special guest today. Mrs. Claus actually came with Santa to be with us. And over my shoulder is her chair. She's going to be reading some Christmas stories to the kids. And I just want to say thank you to Vicki McKenna for donating the beautiful Christmas tree that is standing behind us. Next year, keep your calendars open because we want to do a Santa's workshop and have the kids come in on a Saturday and make the ornaments for this beautiful tree for next year's event. Also, over my other shoulder is Santa's Express. It pulled in the other day, and we want to thank Noreen and Jim Moterly for making this beautiful train for us. It's our photo op booth. So you'll continue to see it over the year as we do other events at the schoolhouse. So let's break and go upstairs and see a couple of other rooms that are decorated for the holidays. I'd like to introduce a special person to us, Vic Fortunato. He very generously donated all the breakfast for the kids today. And so if anybody needs any catering needs, please give him a call. And we're standing next to his sign so we can advertise. But Vic, why did you do this?
I don't know. It's just a great cause. You know, it's Christmas. It's Santa. It's what it's all about. So when they asked me to do it, I said, yeah, I'll take care of it. That's least I can do, and it's a great cause, the Historic Society. I love this whole building and how they're redoing everything. So it was just a pleasure to do it.
Well, we certainly appreciate it because, you know, without the support of the community, we wouldn't be able to do all that we do. And it's important for us to open up the building, have people in, and what better way to have all these kids in with Santa. And I hope you got to sit on Santa's lap.
Oh, well, yeah, definitely, yeah. I need a lot of presents, so I have a big list to give them, so. Okay.
Well,
yeah.
From the bottom of our hearts, thank you very much, and Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
Here we are in our train room, and I want to introduce our chief engineer, Jim Moterly, who actually happens to be my cousin's husband. But Jim very graciously donated all the time. We had these two train platforms, the Suhi family and also the Lorenz family donated these trains that were their children's from the 1960s. And we thought it was important to bring a train back into the building for the kids for Breakfast with Santa. So, Jim, I don't want to embarrass you on camera, but I just want to say thank you for all of your efforts. And say
Merry Christmas. It was natural. I grew up with it.
Okay.
I used to do it at home when my dad got tired of setting it up, and that's how I learned how to do it. And we have a nice little layout here.
Well, it's great, and the kids certainly have appreciated it. So thank you so much for all your time. And also thank you to you and Noreen for doing the train express for the photo op.
That was mostly Noreen.
Good. Good. All right. Thank you, Jim.
You're welcome. Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Thank
you for having me.
So we're all excited. We have a special guest today, Santa and Mrs. Claus. This is his chair. As you can see, he already shipped a bag of coal for those kids that may not have been good this year, but he's got some other surprises in his goodie bag. We've got a list of all the children that are participating today, so if we just wait a few minutes, I think I hear some sleigh bells.
Very good. You straighten his antlers up a little bit.
Yeah,
they have to go up. Yeah, they have to go up.
Too much love.
What's your key for?
Very well, maybe a little bit, huh? How are you? You have the Nightmare Before Christmas hat.
Look at me out there.
I have two more. What is your key for?
What's my key for? That's my magic key. If you don't have a chimney at your house,
I told you that before. I told you that's what it was.
Santa can always get into the house and they can read presents to
him.
Always have something special. Only works on one night though. Only works on Christmas Eve. So yeah, Christmas magic's only one night a year.
Yeah.
Reindeer only fly one night a year.
Well, Santa, thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy schedule to come to the Bethel Park Historical Society. I know the kids certainly enjoyed seeing you. And, you know, I had given you a letter, and I had asked for $1 million to renovate the building. So I hope you know, you've got something in your bag for me on the 25th.
Well, I hope I will. That's a very special thing to ask for, and I hope very much that we will be able to accomplish that for you.
Well, good.
That $1 million for you. So it's important to, so that you can keep your goals ahead of you and reach the goal that you want to reach here.
Okay.
I think it's very important.
I'm counting on you, Santa.
I'll do the best I can.
All right. And, you know, thank you for bringing Mrs. Claus with you today.
Oh,
also.
Welcome.
I think the kids enjoyed meeting her, and I know she's been doing story time in the other room.
Well,
So I'm
glad that she was able to help out today. And Mrs. Claus is a big help to Santa. So
good.
She's able to come and help me do things like this, and I'm sure she's very happy that we can do it.
Santa worked for the post office. When everyone could see he was doing his job, Santa's favorite part of bringing packages to people all over town. Waiting in traffic was frustrating. It's silly to waste all this time, he decided. To speed things up, he started making deliveries in the middle of the night. But there was a problem. So no one was glad to see him at that hour. The postmaster got so many complaining letters that Santa had to leave. Look at here. So hoping to get some exercise, Santa then found a spot at the zoo. He was very organized about the animals. I know when they are sleeping, said Santa, and when they're awake. Over time, he also learned whether they're behaving themselves or not. There was a problem. Santa became close friends with the reindeer, and all the other animals got jealous. Sadly, the zookeeper had to let him go. By now, Santa was starting to get discouraged. He didn't even notice that the reindeer were doing behind him. They worked hard to cheer him up. Oh no! Together, they joined the circus. Soon the reindeer were shooting Santa out of a cannon, 3 times a night. Santa liked flying through the air and wearing his new costume. The elves made Santa a special sack. That was always big enough. No matter how many toys were put in it, then they built him a sleigh. The polar bears offered to pull it. They were very strong and whipped Santa across the snow. But there was a problem. It was the biggest one yet. Uh-oh. To Santa's surprise, the problem couldn't be solved. Santa and the reindeer practiced every day. They made a few mistakes at first, but soon they learned to work as a team. There we go. In the darkest part of winter, when people need their spirit. Huh?
I talked.
You did?
Yeah.
When people need their spirits lifted the most, Santa got ready to go. As the elves said goodbye, they gave Santa an emergency kit. Can I finish the story? As the elves said goodbye, they gave Santa an emergency kit. It had a compass, ski goggles, cough drops, and other things. Santa thanked them very much. All his drops had taught him it was good to be prepared. There's Santa. Then Santa and his reindeer took off. That first night was a little hard because Santa was still learning about shortcuts and high winds, and at last he got the hang of it. Ever since then, the elves had made toys all year, and Santa has given them away, bless you. And one night, he loves his job as much as ever, and he's gotten pretty good at it over the years. Still, he always keeps his emergency kit close by. Because no job is perfect. the end. That was good.
You know, I just want to introduce Brenda Mercer-Klein, and she was really instrumental. She's been a member of the Historical Society for the past year and a half, and has really just contributed so much in our various fundraisers over the course of the year. And she really was the event coordinator for Breakfast with Santa. So, Brenda, thank you so much.
You're so welcome, Bill.
It's been a labor of love, I know. And this building has such a great significance to both of us since our families went to school here. So I look forward to working with you on future events. But anything you'd like to say?
I am so ready for next year.
Hey.
We're going to do it again.
Absolutely. And what are you going to do, Shamrocks?
We're going to do Shamrocks in February? Schoolhouse.
Okay.
We'll start after Valentine's Day.
Okay.
We'll look around the local schools. Not schools, I'm sorry. Businesses.
Okay.
Or buy a shamrock. Donate dollar minimum.
And I know last year you started this campaign and it raised well over $600, which was great because you actually bought a window for us. And that's, you know, during the course of the year, we've had so many changes to the buildings. We replaced 107 windows. We've gone classroom by classroom renovating the building. We've had the trolley repainted. And we've done a lot of fundraising. And I think we've really bolstered the community's interest in this project, getting it up and running, restoring it, turning it into a cultural center. This year, we've got a lot of plans for other fundraising events. Last week, we hosted a birthday party for 15 five-year-olds. So if anybody in the community is looking to host an event, whether it be a birthday party, a political fundraiser, a board meeting for their organization, you know, just please contact us on the Bethel Park Historical Society Facebook page. And Brenda, I think that's a wrap for this year, right?
Yay!
Merry Christmas and happy holidays, everybody. Happy Hanukkah. Thank you very much.
Santa and Mrs. Claus are going to read The Night Before Christmas to you, okay? Here's the story right here. It's a poem, and it was written in 1822. So it's a long, long time ago. And it's about a little old elf named Santa Claus. No, it's not very long. All right, here we go. You ready? Okay, 'twas the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were all nestled, all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief, and I in my cap, had just settled down for a long winter's nap. When out on the lawn there rose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave a luster of midday of objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and eight tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles, there his coursers they came, and he whistled and he shouted, and he called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donder and Blitzen. Two pages. There you go. To the top of the porch, to the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all. As dry leaves before the wild hurricanes fly, when they meet with the obstacles, mount to the sky. So up on the housetop, the coursers, they flew, with sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas, too. And then in a twinkling, I heard on the roof, the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and a beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. Ho, 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 ho. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf. And I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk. And laying his finger aside of his nose, gave a nod, and up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. And I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, "Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night." The end. So Merry Christmas, everyone. Everybody be good now.
Well, thanks again, and
welcome.
And good luck in a couple of weeks.
Yeah, it's going to be a busy night. I can tell you that right now.
All right, everybody. It's a wrap at the Bethel Park Historical Society to the first annual Breakfast with Santa, and we hope to see you all next year at an even larger event. So, Santa, please put us back in your calendar.
I will definitely do that. I'll put you right on down on the schedule.
Great. Thanks
so
much.
Very good. Bye-bye. It's been wonderful being here.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for having us.